Hi students, this is Vishwanath, chemistry faculty for NEET and IIT exams. In last class we completed some of the numericals related to Rydberg equation. See the next one. The wavelength of the radiation emitted by hydrogen when compared to He plus ion is. So hydrogen and He plus ion both are given. In this wavelength comparison they give, for this see the answer. For hydrogen atom, Rydberg equation 1 by lambda 1 equal to R into Z1 square into 1 by N1 square minus 1 by N2 square. And for He plus ion, this is the Rydberg equation. So now ratio we want, wavelength. 1 by lambda 2 divided by 1 by lambda 1 and corresponding right hand side formula. Now from this, Rydberg constant R get cancelled. These two terms get cancelled, then remaining is lambda 1 by lambda 2 equal to Z2 square by Z1 square. Here Z1 means atomic number of hydrogen, Z2 means atomic number of He plus ion. So Z2 means 2 square by 1 square, that equal to this one, lambda 1 equal to 4 into lambda 2. Lambda 1 is the wavelength of the radiation emitted from hydrogen, lambda 2 wavelength of the radiation emitted for He plus ion. That means this wavelength is 4 times to this wavelength. Then what is the option? Option C is the answer, 4 times that of He plus ion. Okay, next, see the next question. The hydrogen line spectrum provides an evidence for the Heisenberg uncertainty principle, wave-like properties of light, diatomic nature of hydrogen, quantized nature of atomic energy states. Here a new word, quantized nature, that means restricted to a particular value. So hydrogen line spectrum provides quantized nature of atomic energy state. It means inside the hydrogen atom energy levels having a particular value. Those type of energy levels are present in or allowed inside the hydrogen atom. The energy levels having energy value of any value do not permitted inside the hydrogen atom. So here quantized nature means restricted to a particular value. Energy levels having a particular value inside the hydrogen atom, those are called quantized nature of energy states. So this fact is revealed by line spectrum of hydrogen atom. So option D is the answer. Next, see the next question. What hydrogen like ion has the wavelength difference between the first lines of Balmer and Lyman series equal to 59.3 nanometer? See here, in the given options, which ion, Balmer series and Lyman series, first lines of Balmer series, Lyman series, wavelength difference if we consider, that is equal to 59.3 nanometer. So that ion we should find out. For this, so this is Rydberg equation. For first line of Balmer series, so Balmer series means N1 value 2, N2 equal to 3, because Balmer series N1 equal to 2, first line means N2 is 3. Substitute in this equation, then we can get this one. So lambda B equal to 36 divided by 5 into RH into Z square. Next, first line of Lyman series. Lyman series means what is N1 value? N1 value is 1. First line means N2 equal to 2. So substitute that N1, N2, then we can get this one. Now this difference, first line of Balmer series and first line of Lyman series, difference is equal to this one. Given value in nanometers, convert that into centimeter, then we can get this one. So lambda B means this, lambda L means this, substitute here, then we can get this one. So finally Z square equal to 9, Z equal to 3. So Z equal to 3 means hydrogen like ion, what is that? Li2 plus, lithium. Atomic number 3 means it represents lithium. In the given options, this is the suitable one. So option B is the answer. Okay, next, see the next one. Calculate the Rydberg constant R if He plus ions are known to have the wavelength difference between the first lines of Balmer and Lyman series equal to 133.7 nanometers. Similar type of question. The difference between previous question and this is here calculation of Rydberg constant, there finding Z value. That only difference. Here also same thing. Wavelength difference between first lines of Balmer series and Lyman series is equal to this. Then we should calculate R value, Rydberg constant value for He plus ion. So first line of Lyman series means this is the formula. This is the substituting values N1, N2. Then we can get this. First line of Balmer series means this one. So this is Lyman series, this is Balmer series. Difference between the wavelengths of Balmer series and Lyman series, substitute, then we can get RH value, that is this. Okay, next, the wave number of first line of Balmer series of hydrogen is 15,200 centimeter inverse. The wave number of first Balmer line of Li2 plus ion, observe carefully, here different species, here hydrogen, first line of Balmer line in hydrogen, value is given. We have to calculate first line of Balmer series in Li2 plus ion. So generally students may do mistake for this type of questions, because in this case also again using Rydberg equation and substituting N1, N2 value and calculating regarding this related to this Li2 plus ion. It is a time taking process. See the simple method. Nu bar, wave number nu bar equal to 1 by lambda equal to RH into 1 by N1 square minus 1 by N2 square. It is related to hydrogen, because for hydrogen Z value 1, first line of Balmer series N1 value 2, first line means N2 value 3. So 1 by 2 square minus 1 by 3 square. This value already given, 15,200 centimeters. For Li2 plus ion, we have to calculate. So, for Li2 plus ion, wave number nu bar equal to Rydberg constant into Z square into. Here also first line of Balmer series. Balmer series first line means N1 value 2, N2 value 3. Substitute 1 by 2 square minus 1 by 3 square. Now, observe these two expressions carefully. What is the difference? Only Z square is the difference. Instead of this, can we write this one? So 15,200 into Z square. Here lithium atomic number Z value 3. Substitute that one, then we can get this one. So simple thing. Again, we need not calculate all these things. Using this value, we can get answer quickly. So option A is the answer. Next. What transition in the hydrogen spectrum would have the same wavelength as the Balmer transition N equal to 4 to N equal to 2 in the He plus spectrum? In He plus spectrum for Balmer series, N equal to 4 to N equal to 2 transition takes place, it has a wavelength. Now, in hydrogen spectrum, which transition having same wavelength as that of this one? So, we have to find out between which energy levels transition takes place in hydrogen spectrum. Its wavelength is equal to wavelength of this transition. Okay. Say this, for He plus ion, for Balmer line, N2 equal to 4, N2, sorry, here N1 equal to 2. N2 equal to 4, N1 equal to 2. Okay, substitute the values, then we can get this one. 1 by N1 square minus 1 by N2 square, we can get this one. In hydrogen, if N2 equal to 2, N1 equal to 1, that is a Lyman series. For example, if we consider fourth option, then N2 equal to 2, N1 equal to 1, Lyman series, then we can get this one. Okay, this type of questions generally heat and trial method only. Okay, so for this suitable option is D. Next, Bohr atomic model. In an art, Niels Bohr explained the atomic, proposed an atomic model to explain the structure of the atom. So in an atom, electrons revolve around the nucleus in definite circular orbits or shells or energy levels. That means just like a solar system, nucleus is present at the center. Around it, electrons are revolving in a fixed circular path. These are called orbits or shells or energy levels. Next, these orbitals are called stationary orbits because the electron can neither emit energy nor absorb energy as long as it moves in a particular orbit. Suppose consider an electron present in the second orbit. Its energy remains constant as long as it is present in the second orbit. That means in a particular orbit electron is revolving, then it cannot exhibit energy, it cannot absorb energy. So energy of these orbits or shells is constant. That's why these are called stationary orbits or stationary shells. In these orbits, the angular momentum of the electron is equal to integral multiple of h by 2 pi. So circular path means they have some angular momentum. Their angular momentum values are integral multiple of h by 2 pi. Integral multiple of h by 2 pi means mvr equal to nh by 2 pi. Here n value 1, 2, 3, 4, n is called principal quantum number. It will come in the next topic. What is principal quantum number? What are the quantum numbers? All these things. Suppose take n value 1, h by 2 pi, 2 h by 2 pi, 3 h by 2 pi, 4 h by 2 pi, like this, integral multiple of h by 2 pi. In those orbits only electrons are present. That means angular momentum of electron in the atom is also quantized. Quantized means having a particular value. M mass of the electron, V velocity of the electron or radius of the orbit, H is the Planck's constant. Next, when an electron transition from one energy level to another one, then that absorbed or evolved energy is equal to difference in energies of two orbits, which is equal to quanta. Suppose from lower energy level to higher energy level, electron transition takes place, then energy is absorbed. Otherwise, or from higher energy level to lower energy level, electron transition takes place, then energy is released. So in this way, in these two cases only, change in energy of the electron takes place. That difference in energy is given by delta E, that is E2 minus E1, that equal to h nu. Here E2 is energy of higher orbit, E1 is energy of lower orbit. Next, the force of attraction between the nucleus and the electron. Electron and nucleus are having opposite charges. They have some attraction force, that is minus ze square by r square. The centrifugal force of attraction due to revolving around the nucleus. That means this attraction force towards the nucleus in the opposite direction, another force is working, that is centrifugal force. For that expression is minus mv square by r. These two forces are equal in magnitude but working in opposite direction, operating in opposite direction. The radius of the Bohr's orbit expression are equal to n square h square by 4 pi square m z e square. For hydrogen atom, z value equal to 1. So radius expression is this. By substituting n h pi m e, finally we can get this one, r equal to 0.529 into 10 power minus 8 centimeter into n square. In angstrom units, r equal to 0.529 into n square angstrom unit. Here n is the orbit number. Next, say this one. For hydrogen like ions, radius of the orbit Rn equal to 0.529 into n square by z angstrom units. Z is the atomic number, n is the orbit number. Now say this Rydberg equation related question. If minimum wavelength in emission spectrum of Li2 plus in passion series is P, then what is the maximum wavelength in emission spectrum of He plus ion in Balmer series? So understand carefully. In Li2 plus ion, minimum wavelength passion series, Lyman-Balmer passion series, N1 value 3. Minimum wavelength is P. And in Balmer series, N1 value 2. Maximum wavelength we should calculate. Say this one. In Li 2 plus ion, minimum wavelength of spectral lines in Paschen series means N1 equal to 3, N2 equal to infinity. Already we completed. Energy level infinity means that gives limiting line. From infinite distance, electron jumping takes place to third orbit. Then we can get spectral line in Paschen series. In that case, energy difference is very large. So wavelength is minimum. So in this given condition, given according to given question, minimum wavelength means N1 value 3, N2 value infinity. Substitute that, then we can get this one. So lambda maximum equal, sorry, this is lambda minimum. Lambda minimum equal to 1 by r equal to p. This is given. If He plus ion maximum wavelength of spectral line Balmer series. Balmer series N1 value is 2. Here maximum wavelength. Maximum wavelength means from third orbit to second orbit, electron transition takes place. It has maximum wavelength. Maximum wavelength means energy difference is less. So we can get this one. So now 9 by 5 r. 1 by r means what is that? P. So 9 by 5 into p. Okay. So option, what is the suitable option? Option D is the answer. We'll meet you in the next class.